Snowcross is similar to motocross. I explain this like this because people know what motocross is. Motocross, you go out on a track, pre-built. Snowcross, same thing, except it's on snow. You got doubles, you got tabletops, you got jumps, you got turns, you got corners, you got the start, you have hills, you have downhills, uphills, whatever. Whatever, it's all just qualifying and racing on a track against anywhere between 4 to 14 other people.
Prior to the race, you and 9 other people will draw pins with numbers on them. You'll line up in accordance to the numbers on the pins on the starting line. After you get settled in, you'll simply look at the flagger who holds a green flag, and when he lifts it up, you'll take off. If you get out front first, you have done what's called a hole shot, which is key to winning a race. Whoops are a series of short bump-like jumps. The key to getting through a section like this on the track is to go through them as fast as you can while keeping the nose of your sled up, and hold on tight because you might come off. Doubles. Doubles are two different jumps that are set apart from a gap of normally around 15 to 30 feet. The goal is to try to clear the gap in between. If you don't, there will be consequences and you'll probably crash. Whoever can float smoothly over the doubles is going to gain the most time and consistently win. Tabletop. Tabletop is normally the jump that is set up for the finish line. So your goal is basically just to get over it, and it's an obstacle that does not have to be cleared. The goal is to land on the downslope of the table, that way you will gain more speed. Cornering. There are two different types of cornering. One of them is squaring. Basically, you come into the corner hot, square it off, and go through at a consistent speed. Another type of cornering is called railing a corner. Basically, what your goal is to try and do is flow through the corner as smoothly as possible while carrying as much speed. That way, you have more exit speed when you exit the corner. Qualifying. Qualifying is basically like going through baseball playoffs into the championship. You'll race three qualifiers, and if you win enough points, you will put into the main event, or if you set the championship. If you do not make enough points by winning the three qualifiers, you will be put into the last place qualifier. If you place top 2 to 4 by the end of that, you will get into the main event.
Personally, I haven't really done much in the past, but it's kind of because I grew up on sleds, so I kind of had this technique just that helped me out. I kind of knew how to work myself. Now I'm going to start running and doing a lot of cardiovascular training and working up my upper body just a little bit. Just that's pretty much it. I work out at Gold's Gym.
I'll usually work out in the gym 3 to 4 days a week, 2 hours a night, to increase strength and endurance and cardiovascular activity. And then as soon as I'm just rambling, and I'll ride my dirt bike to train and ride it well and hard. Then about 2 months before the season, I go into personal training with the trainer and work out probably about 6 to 8 hours a week, push it really hard. And then during the season, you basically just want to ride and work out to make sure that you're in shape for the next race.
Travis, how you feel today?
You know how to work that pump pretty good.
Yeah.
Yes, brother.
Little kid looked at us, man.
You ready to go riding?
Yeah, I want to go riding. Let's
go riding, riding.
Well, SnoCross has done a lot of things for me. It's made me a better person. It got me in shape, kept me fit, kept me healthy, even through all the injuries that I've sustained. But most of all, I just had to say it's made me a better person. It's made me work harder for what I want in life. Even if it gets tough, I still keep trying. And made me more of an individual, because it's kind of an individual sport, even though you have a lot of people around, and it's brought me closer to my family, for sure.
SnoCross has made me spend lots of money, and I've met a few friends, a few good people, and I've spent a lot of money. Well, with my two goons of partners, it's kind of the last few years been interesting. I didn't race 2 seasons ago, but I still got to live on the road with these guys, and they keep you kind of busy throughout the whole racing season, be it in the truck, on the track, in the trailer, or 4 o'clock in the morning.
It takes big support, you know. For one thing, you definitely have to have your parents behind you, because they're probably going to be your main sponsor if you're a privateer. And You know, it just takes a lot of money, a lot of time, a lot of effort gets put out to race, and without that, I don't think I would be where I'm at today. Probably my worst injury, fingers crossed, has been a concussion that I sustained in Minnesota. And I've been landed on before, so I've had back injuries, I've strained knees, but luckily no broken bones, and my fingers crossed, knock on wood, for that one.
If you go about it the correct way, yes. If you don't, no. If you get the right group of people, yes. If you don't have the right group of people, it could definitely not. It just depends on how many people are motivated to make it turn into a group of sport.
And I come into